Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 15 brings a bunch of new refinement and features. And so I wanted to show you one of my favorite or most helpful features, and that's called focus. If you're familiar with Do Not Disturb on iOS 14, focus mode enhances that to give you many more options and much more customization. So I wanted to walk you through those different options, how you can use them, and how you can even customize them based on your location, time of day, or even the app you open, which will switch between the different modes. So in your control center, you'll see it says Do Not Disturb. And if I tap on this, you'll see I have a bunch of different options now. I have work, sleep, weekend, mindfulness, home evening, and driving. And I can even add more, and I can highly customize each one of these. This has replaced Do Not Disturb in your settings as well. So if you go into settings, scroll down, you'll see it now says focus instead of Do Not Disturb. All of those same modes are available here as well. So you have the same options here with an option to quickly enable them in your control center. And so I wanted to show you how to customize those. So first let's customize them. Then I'll show you how you can automate them, and then also how you can enable them throughout the day manually as well. And so the first thing is we have a bunch of different options, and you'll see it says share across devices. Now, when you're sharing across devices, they will automatically enable across your devices, including your Apple Watch and your iPad or your Mac or whatever you have set up with the latest versions of iOS, iPadOS, WatchOS, and macOS. And so the first thing is we have Do Not Disturb. That's here automatically, driving, and the others. But maybe we want to customize one. So we can do that by pressing on the plus button. Within the plus button, you'll see it says, what do you want to focus on? Custom, fitness, gaming, personal, or reading. So we'll select custom, and under custom, we can name it to whatever we'd like. So maybe we'll just name it new focus, just so I can show you an example. Now under new focus, we have the option for different colors. So we can select whatever color we'd like, and then also give it an icon that represents the focus we're talking about. So you have some books, and you can scroll down and see a bunch of different ones, from shapes to books to maybe transit, some headphones. We'll just leave it alone for now, but you get the idea that you can customize it based on what you'd like. Once you've done that, tap on next. And now it's going to give you the option to allow people to give you notifications, even if that focus mode is enabled. So maybe you have some people that are critical that they contact you during your focus mode, whether that be a family member or child or significant other, or even employers or employees, you'll be able to add them within your contacts here to allow those notifications to come through. So you can add a person, remove all the people, or just have people from your favorites. So it's up to you if you want those notifications to come through or not. So you can allow those or allow none. I'll tap on allow none, and then it gives us the option to allow apps for notifications. So we have a bunch of different apps. Maybe we get a ton of notifications from mail or Instagram or Twitter or anything else. We can either allow those or fully disallow those. So we can add an app, and you'll see that they're categorized alphabetically. So you have all of your different apps, and whether or not you want notifications from them is completely up to you during that focus mode. I have some customized for work and some for home, and just however you want it set up is up to you and relevant to what you're doing at that time. So you can set that up if you want notifications from fitness or FaceTime or not at all. It's up to you. You can also allow apps that are time sensitive to come through. So maybe you have a calendar set up with meetings and you want those to come through either way. You may want to turn that on so that will allow apps not in your allowed list to send notifications marked as time sensitive immediately. So maybe you need to not miss that meeting. It will still come through even if the focus mode is enabled. So we'll go ahead and tap on allow. And the next thing it says, your focus is ready. Now, that's the basics of setting up a focus mode, but there's a lot more within that focus mode. But first, let me show you how to enable it. Now, it's pretty easy. You can just go into your control center, tap on the focus mode you want, and then maybe enable work. Once I do that, it will immediately enable it on nearby devices that are tied to the account because I have that option selected. If I go back to new focus, it will enable new focus. And you'll see it flips to that mode. And if I go to my Apple Watch, it will do the same. If I scroll down, you'll see the little smiley face there. It's enabled across all of my devices. Again, that takes place across driving or do not disturb. And there's options that are slightly different between different sorts of focus modes. And what I mean by that is if you are in a driving focus mode, you can have it auto respond. So within a driving focus mode, you have the option to auto reply. So you can auto reply with a message saying I'm driving, or you can change that entirely. You can turn on the focus modes within settings as well. Just go to the different ones and turn it on here, enable it this way, or your control center, or however you'd like. So it's really easy to enable. And of course, you can use Siri as well to enable those. So if I press and hold, or I can say Siri with the word hey in front of it, let's go ahead and try this. Enable the sleep focus mode. And you'll see it says I turned on sleeping mode, or I turned sleeping mode on. So it will enable it using Siri or however you'd like. You have multiple options. But the best way to enable these, I think, is through customization based on location. So if we go into our new focus that we created already, we have the option to add a schedule or automation. Now we can customize our home screen and lock screen to go along with this. I'll show that in just a moment, but you can add a schedule or automation to enable the focus mode based on time, location, or app, or smart activation. It will learn what you do over time and then suggest that focus mode. So you can do that if you'd like, but I like to use location, but you can use location or time. When I arrive at work, flip to the work mode. When I arrive home, switch back to home. And it works pretty seamlessly. And I have that enabled just like that. When I arrive home, it switches to home evening for me. But we can schedule a time. And so you can schedule it based on time of day and day. So we'll just hit done to set it as default. And you'll see it automatically switch to that new focus mode because it's within that time frame. So every day it will turn on the new focus mode between 9 a.m. and 5 p.m. in my time zone, it will just turn on automatically. Once it hits 5 p.m., it will switch off. So it's set up that way, but you can set it up based on location, like I said, or wherever you'd like. When you arrive at someone's house, you arrive home, arrive to work, or so on. So it's really nice and works very, very well. And another thing that I really like is the option to change your home screen based on that focus. With prior iOS versions, we had the option to change our home screens and customize them with different apps. You'll see I have a home screen and I have the app library. But if I press and hold and go into jiggle mode, tap on the dots here at the bottom, we have all of our different home screens and I can customize these to be active during a specific focus mode. So I can have it set up one way for one focus mode and an entirely different way for a different focus mode. So the first thing you'll need to do is customize your home screens. In order to do that, you'll need to turn off all focus modes altogether. So turn off your focus mode, just tap on it, turns it off, or you could use Siri, and now you've got your home screens. Press and hold, go into jiggle mode, and then you can go into your home screens. You can enable one or just create an entirely new custom home screen. Here's one I created that might work for fitness. So you'll see this one just has three widgets. It has your music, your activity, and the weather. So maybe you want to go outside, you want to check the weather beforehand, you can do that. It can be customized however you'd like, and that's why you can add multiple icons. I could add music to this home screen and a separate home screen. You can fully customize it to your liking now. So now, if we go back into our focus modes, we'll go into our new focus, we'll enable that, tap on the three dots, tap on settings, and within here, you'll see we have home screen. Under home screen, we have the option to hide our notification badges. So we don't want to be bothered by the notification badges on our home screen. We also have the option to select custom pages. So let's do that. So you'll see I have our home screen. I want my home screen enabled and maybe this screen enabled during this specific focus mode. We'll hit done. And you'll see that I have those two pages selected. And during this focus, I want all of the notification badges turned off. You'll see I have no notification badges now. None of them are there, so they don't distract me during this focus mode. Now, if I switch to a different focus, maybe I switch to Do Not Disturb, go back home, you'll see I have the same pages because I just customized them that way. However, if I switch to maybe Work, go back home, you'll see all of a sudden I have a bunch of different home pages enabled. So there's a bunch of them enabled. As I switch back to a different focus mode, our new focus that we just created, and we'll just turn it on for an hour now, you'll see now we only have two home screens. So now we can fully customize based on time of day, where we're located, based on our focus mode. sleep even, what it looks like. It changes our home screen, changes our notification, mutes them, and also holds them later on for us in our notification dropdown. So if I pull down notifications, you'll see there's our notification center. And should I've gotten a bunch of notifications, it will let me know throughout the day that these were held during your focus mode. And then you can expand those and look at those. You also have the option to customize your lock screen as well. If you go into lock screen within your settings, you can dim the lock screen during your focus mode or silence your notifications, but show them on your lock screen. You can also change the focus modes on the lock screen. So if we go to the lock screen, tap the focus mode, we can change them from here. So we have all of this customization with the option to switch between all of these different focus modes that will sync between our devices and is smart and knows where we are and switches based on that throughout the day. You can customize this as much as you'd like or not at all. You don't have to use it, but it's nice to have this level of customization to really help focus throughout the day. I find that it helps tremendously when I'm filming a video, I flip on do not disturb. When I'm at work, it's on work. At night, it automatically switches to sleep. And on the weekend, it switches to weekend where I don't have any distractions and I can relax. So you have all of these different options. And again, for driving while you're driving. So you have all of these different options that are incredibly helpful, highly customizable, and I think are one of the best things I've seen in a long time to be on iOS. So hopefully that helps you understand focus a little bit better. And if you have any other questions or suggestions, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.